What's up, creators? Today we're going to talk about the built-in transition effects available in VSDC. The editor comes with 11 built-in transitions, and some of them are cinematic, more complex effects, others are pretty basic, but will come in handy if you are working on a slideshow or a presentation. We'll review all of them one by one, and at the end of the video, we'll show you how to apply the classic versions of fade-in and fade-out transitions even though they are not in the menu. Stay tuned till the end. Let's get started. Once you add your footage to the timeline, open the Video Effects menu and find Transitions. The first transition in the list is called Paper Burn. This effect imitates the look of burning paper, and like most effects in VSDC, it's highly customizable. You can adjust the speed and direction of the effect, as well as the size and color of the flame. But most importantly, by using the time inversion parameter, you can make it look as if the video is being destroyed by burning or the opposite, being recovered from it. Moving on, the flow transformation effect distorts the image using a unique distortion pattern and makes it look as if it's dissolving into the next scene. We used this transition for the tutorial on the Star Trek transporter effect. Make sure to check it out, it's pretty awesome. The shattered glass effect is a beautiful, dramatic transition that helps you make it look as if the image is being shattered into pieces or being restored after being shattered. Again, there is a lot you can fine-tune here, including the type of fracturing, the speed of the shards, and even the backside color of the pieces. To learn more, watch a detailed tutorial linked in the top right corner. Paint brush is one of our favorite transition effects. It's a simple yet elegant effect that imitates a paint brush covering or uncovering the video you've applied to the effect to. Normally, you would want to use the former option if you're placing the transition at the end of the video, and the latter option if you're placing the transition at the beginning of the video. The remaining transition effects are pretty standard, and you'll probably guess what they look like just by reading their names. For example, the chess effect creates a gradual transition through a fade-in chessboard. The wipe transition wipes the video off the scene in the direction you choose from the preset menu. The push effect literally pushes the video away from the scene. The mosaic effect brings over a dozen transition options, including spirals, strips, dissolve, and so on. The page turn effect may sound simple and basic, but it can actually help you create a cool-looking effect where you're in control of the page turn direction, the curl angle, and even the size of the shadow created by the turning page. Diffuse FX creates a gradual diffusion effect from either side of the scene, and here you can control the size of the particles. And finally, the Fade FX. It comes with several transition presets that are indispensable if you are working on a presentation or a photo slideshow. Now, if you were waiting for the classic fade-in and fade-out transitions to appear in this overview, your time is now. Although they aren't included in the transitions menu, you can easily use them as such. Just open the transparency section and apply the fade-in effect if you want the video to gradually appear in the scene, and the fade-out effect if you want it to gradually disappear. Before we finish, remember that you can apply transitions to any objects in the scene, including text object, shapes, and images. Go ahead and try it for yourself. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below. Thank you for watching. Until next time.